Hello, I welcome all of you to today's learning session, and the session will be on nature of educational psychology. So before proceeding this session, dear students, I sincerely request all of you to watch previous videos relating to concept of psychology so that you can clearly understand what we have already discussed, and your understanding will be at the top level and you will be clear about everything. So you must watch the previous video relating to our discussion, and this is the part 7 of our discussion, and here we will discuss the nature of educational psychology. Educational psychology is a science of education, so its nature must be scientific. Natures are scientific. We can summarize the nature of educational psychology in some headings and in following ways. First, educational psychology is a science. Like a science, educational psychology, it adopts objective methods for data collection. Science has its objectives of understanding, explaining, predicting, and controlling effects. Educational psychology also has the same objective of understanding, predicting, explaining, and controlling of human behavior. So educational psychology is a science. Next, educational psychology is a natural science. An educational psychologist conducts experiments, investigations, gathers different data from different sources, and reaches to conclusion exactly in the same way the biologist or physicist. So it is a natural science. Then educational psychology is a social science. Like any other sociologist, like sociologist, anthropologist, political scientist, educational psychologist deals with the study of human behavior and their sociability. So it is a social science. Then educational psychology is a positive science. Educational psychology is a positive science. In the previous discussion also, we know what is a positive science. Every time positive science gives importance to what is real in nature, the real reality, it gives importance to the reality. So normative science like logic and ethics, they deals with the facts as they ought to be. But positive science, it deals with facts as it is. Educational psychology also deals with human nature or individual nature or nature of child as it is, not it out to be. So it gives importance to the reality, not imaginal, but exact behavior of the individual is studied in educational psychology. So it is a positive science. It gives importance to the real nature of human being. It do not ask question what the individual should do, but what they are actually doing in practical life situation, it gives importance to it. Then educational psychology is an applied science. It is the application of psychological principle in the field of education. By applying principle and techniques of psychology in the field of education, it tries to study human behavior and also their experiences in different fields. So educational psychology is an applied science. It always applies the knowledge of pure branch of psychology to the field of education. Then educational psychology is a developing or growing science. We can say educational psychology a developing or growing science because it give importance to new researches, and so many researches are conducting in the field of educational psychology day by day, and new results are coming out, and giving importance to the new results or basing on new results, it gets educational psychology always gets insight into the behavior of its children or individual. So education psychology is a developing science. It is always developing. It conducts different type of researches relating to human behavior in different fields. So it is a developing science. It is always reach to new conclusions, reach to new direction, reach to new knowledge. It always gives the psychologist a new insight. So educational psychology is a developing science or growing science. So in our today's discussions, we have discussed the nature of educational psychology. Educational psychology is a science of education. We can say it is a science of education and its nature are scientific. So dear students, very very thanks to all of you for watching today's video, and the next video will be on scope of educational psychology. So you need to wait for that video and stay safe at home and continue your study online. You have no need to excuse yourself. You have various scope through online method. You can progress through online classes. So very very thanks to all of you. Thank you.